this version was before the other translated version of the King James 611. So how they going to tell you what is correct and what is not correct when the Most High had ordained it? Read Deuteronomy chapter 17, and I believe it's Mark chapter 13, verse 10, because this is the only book that is published throughout the four corners of the earth. So if I want a copy of the King James, wouldn't I get the one that he put together? Think about it. But let me show you the evidence and proof, because this is the proof of what the Roman Catholics have done and what the Protestants have done. And if you know somebody that's a Catholic, get a copy of their Bible, because one of my sisters confessed to me, because she know of a Catholic personally, and his Bible is totally different from what you have of the new translated King James Version or the other translated King James Version. They have those other books that we do not have in America. So this is why I'm recommending you to get your copy of the 1611 Day or the 1611 Holy Bible. In that book, Yahuwah has given us many clues and evidence of his truth through his precepts, despite of what the heathens have done. And what I mean by that, how they inserted the word Easter, how they inserted a 18th century word, which is Jew, in there when it should have been Judean, okay? Even you can see some other discrepancies in the Bible, because what has happened now, many has mistaken word corruption as being correct. However, if you have that 1611 and you read the side notes, it will show you what was the word corruptions and what was the correct word transliteration. But you need a spirit yard to open your eyes. But let me go to the evidence and proof, because the Ethiopians kept the original, the original format of the King James 1611. So let me go here. Israelites and Gentiles. Read that book for yourself. And if you do not understand anything, you seek Yah. Read Luke 11, 9 to 13. Because the word said it is his spirit that should teach us, as written in 1 John chapter 2, verse 27, and John chapter 14 to John chapter 16. The Messiah's spirit is our comforter. He is our teacher. And when you understand his position, his spirit, then you understand why man cannot teach you this, why man cannot show you the whole truth. For it's the Messiah's spirit who dwells in us that show us all truth.